Hello everybody and welcome back to Okami. It is me, Ralphie993, and we are inside the Imperial Palace. But again, we are very small. But that's okay, oh my gosh, because even though these spiders are huge compared to us, last episode we saw the god of time, Kasugami, I believe its name was. It was a sheep, a very drunk sheep, mind you. And it gave us the ability to warp time, make it slow, make it slow. But that's okay, because now we can get past the blocking spiders, and we can also progress through the dungeon, which is wonderful. So there's some amazing flippy acrobatics across here. Am I going the right way? I don't recall. Spider? No. Oh yeah, we're the right way. This is the room with all the feet. This is where we want to be. Now before, if you try to get past these guys, these brooms would get in the way, because they would just follow you. They seem to realize that we are a dust bunny, and we couldn't get past them. But now, with the power of time, we can. So we'll just do it. Oh, that just sped its way across. We can speed our way by it, though, and progress through the dungeon. Sweetness. Because, yeah, we already found the treasure room of this place. And we also found, a girl, actually, locked away where, I guess, the Emperor imprisoned her, even though she doesn't really know why, which is kind of bizarre. But we sent Issun over, and he got us an Infinity Stone. Yeah, so that's kind of bizarre. I believe her name was Kaguya, and if you do recall, she was the girl that, not wind, I would like water, please. Thank you. She was the girl that Mr. Bamboo kept talking about. Oh, my dear Kaguya, where have you been, my dear Kaguya? Or something along those lines. Oh my gosh, I hope you don't fall. But yeah, just use these bamboo sticks. Oh, did I mess that up? Run across them, and you can get across the poison pond. And hi, little of our spidery friends. Come on, let's go. Thank you. Leads us up here. I assume everything makes that noise, but ooh. Oh, that looks like it's, he is definitely the source of that nasty green mist. Hmm. Hey, look over there, Ami. Isn't that the Emperor? I heard that he was sick in bed, but I never expected him to be the source of that funky mist. Now how are we going to straighten out this royal oaf? I mean, we're still too big to fit through this mosquito net. Yeah, we will not fit through there, but we'll have to find another way around. Now, oh, these scrolls. There's two scrolls here. Are they important to fight? Yes, because they have new enemies, so we'll do that. Alright, oh, they don't. We've seen these enemies before. I've been lied to. Oh, thanks. Leave me alone. We got both a Wind Doom and a Thunder Doom mirror in here. Hopefully, we can stop. Ah, all the pain. Die, foul beasts. I said the mirrors kind of scary because they actually have like faces on them. Like, just the creepy eyes were scary before, and like, you know, the ears and the. Oh crap! What is it? Power slash? No, I messed that up. But like the wooden wheel, elemental wooden wheels are kind of scary, but these ones are creepier because, I don't know, they just seem meaner, more aggressive. Oh, I want that holy bone! Yes! Barely missed it. But this one over here might have the other two of that family. Maybe? Yes, over here we have the Fire Doom Mirror and the Ice Doom. So, that's good. So I was partially right, I just wrote down in my notes the wrong one. Okay. Oh, did I kill that one already? I think I did. Stop hitting me! Stop it, why can't I hit you? Stop it, oh my gosh, they're hard. Just die, please. Alright. The ice one really went down quickly. But this guy is a little bit more temperamental. That's fine, we'll just destroy him. There we go. And I believe Gale Storm, his floral finisher. Gale Storm, please. Yeah, Gale Storm. And I believe the Ice Doom here has probably Inferno as her floral finisher as well. We can go take a quick peek at their bestiary entries before we figure out our way how to. Ooh, shadows. Anyways, whoa, that was weird. Let's read up on that. Because their stories are kind of cool too. So let's see here. Fire Doom Mirror. A man possessed by extreme fury was unable to forget his rage even after death, resulting in his soul being absorbed into his favorite mirror. Anger is stirred by gazing at the mirror even with no logical pretense. This is the method of the Fury Field Mirror. Blowing on the mirror may snuff the flames of intense rage. So yeah, he's an angry one. Alright, and the Ice Doom Mirror. A beautiful and popular actress hoped to retain her looks forever. This hope became obsession, and her soul was sucked into her mirror. Gazing into the mirror reveals a pretty woman. Those who smile at her die instantly. We must remind the actress of her inner warmth. It is said that she bathed her mirror in flame before acting. You would think bathing a mirror in fire would, like, temper it incorrectly? I really have no idea. Like, you know, might be more brittle and more prone to cracking and such. Anyways, chick. Inky spider. More spiders. You can see all the little webs that they work upon. Ah, thank you, kind sir. They even have little faces on their backs, but they're less noticeable than the blocking spiders, which are definitely a face. Alright, no, come back here, please. No! Oh, silly spiders. Whoop, let's not do that again. Oh, made it this time. Alright, no. Oh, made it too. Wonderful. Okay. We're up to the top. So yeah, so clearly we don't need to go through the mosquito net. We'll just walk our way up and around it. Thanks to all these handy little spiders. Although, are the spiders in proper scale to the rest of it? That's my next question. I feel like the spiders are really big compared to everything else in this area. Alright, I want the treasure chest. We don't want to be hit by the blocking spiders. And you don't have to use Veil of Mist, you can just run across too. They're kind of slow. Oh, but you obtained the Imperial Palace map. Again, another example of how these maps come extremely late in the actual dungeons, because pretty much the end of the dungeon is right below us, where the mist is coming from, right over there. But we're going to gather all the treasures and stuff up here. I'm going to slow this guy down, because this is kind of a narrow little passageway. Ami, why'd you do that for? Thankfully, she just respawns right back up at the top. But I thought there was a treasure chest over here, or did I do all this for nothing? Ah, there's one, but spider webs are blocking it, so we'll just use Issun to go get it. Oh, Ami, stop doing that, man. Stop it. I keep, like, just slightly, don't hit me, bumping my nunchuck, and she just goes like flying off in different directions. Alright, I think we want to go this way next. Go! Ah! Yeah, I want to go back to the beginning. So now we're gonna head this way. Alright, definitely I feel like they're swinging way too fast for my liking. You know what? Let's just keep it like that. Let's jump on this blue guy! Because they're super fast! Oh my gosh! They're speedy spiders, so use time to slow them down as well so you can make the jumps. You could try to jump across without slowing down time, which it can be done. I have tried it before, but it's just more It's more for sure that you're not gonna mess that up if you use Veil of Mist. So let's get that treasure chest back there. I'll leave Issun to do that. We got a vengeance slip that'll come in handy later. Oh my gosh, so many spiders! And you can see the ones in the back are really moving. So we're just gonna have to keep up our Veil of Mist. Ah ha ha. Oh, there we go. And we have approached the green mist. Ooh, oh, he does not look good either. He's all blue with like really red and swollen eyes. Ugh, that's sickness. Check it out, Ami. The Emperor's directly below us. It's like the Royal Oaf's mouth just begging us to dive on in. Well, I can do that. Whee! Surprise, even in sickness, probably would realize that and choke a little bit on it, but ugh. Ah, are we inside the Emperor's body now? Wow, Ami, you're one fearless wolf. This should be the fastest way to get to the root of the problem. It's because uvula. Hey, what's this funny looking thing here? Oh, I know. It's that dangly thing that hangs down the back of the throat. I bet if we tickled it, this royal oaf would sneeze. That's probably our best bet for getting out of here. But let's save that for later. We're going the other way now. Yeah, we're going the other way. We are heading towards the other end of the digestive system, I guess. Don't worry, we won't get that far. No. We are not getting that far. But oh, we could save. We could. Nah, we don't need to save. We can do it. Wonder what's in there. I have a feeling we're in for trouble. You're not gonna turn back now, are you, Ami? Wanna turn back? No way! We got this. Good answer. Okay, you know the drill. Leap before you think! Leap we shall. Alright, oh, the green mist is so much thicker here. Oh, look at all the blood vessels lining the esophagus, I guess, where we are. Ah, it's so... so biological looking. Oh, leap. Leap indeed. Ugh. It's a sword in him. A little sword. It's like a toothpick sword. No way. This is insane. That mist. It's alive, Ami. Oh gosh. Under my control, this body breathes evil mist over the city. And you, mutt. You dare attempt to clear the skies of my poison? Waging battle with me inside a human body will be no easy task. Even now, Goldnail, the mighty sword, cries out for your blood. Come, step forward so that I, the indomitable Blight, may cut you down. Oh wow, Issun. I'll step forward, all right. You're a real piece of work, Blight. Better say your prayers. You uncultured wretch. Be warned. We are in the very bowels of the Emperor. If we fight here, his body will not. Give me a break. A little action here will help him wake up. But never mind that. You're the one behind that poison mist. Possessing a human body may be an elaborate trick, but it ends now. With my supreme blade, Denkumaru, I, the magnificent Issun, shall rend that hunk of junk you call a sword. Oh, no, no, Issun. I don't think you can take him. Not by yourself. The power of teamwork! Alright, this is Blight, the boss of the Imperial Palace. I don't recall how to fight him. You just basically- Oh shit, yes! Use Veil of Mist all the time. And when his mist disappears, ah, I can't recall it. So he does little like triggering moves like that to show you he's gonna start attacking. And he shifts across super fast and is attacking then. Maybe. Can you not be covered in mist? Ooh, ooh, what's he doing? Oh, this is what you want him to do. Okay. He does this move where he has all these swords. Power slash all of them. And then go after Goldnail. The main sword. Alright, can we power slash it? I don't know if power slash really does anything. But that's the thing, it explodes though too. It's kind of a pain in the butt. I must say, out of all the boss fights, this is the one I always have the hardest time with. Like, I either seem to do really well on the other ones, I figure out the pattern, it's all down pat. But Blight, I never seem to be able to figure out properly. I don't know, it's weird. But anyways, he's gonna do that thing again. Just keep hitting him, I suppose. Oh, don't hit him when he's all... Okay, what are you doing now, buddy? Oh, looks like he's gonna prepare for an attack again. Yeah, that attack. I don't know if actually hitting him does anything. Oh wait, yes it did, because Blight is now... or Goldnail is now gone. Come on, can we... if this works? I'm not sure. Just basically always attack Goldnail. And... yeah, power slash does not definitely work, but yeah, it does this explosion of green goop that always hurts Amaterasu, or at least pushes her back, for sure, but oh well. Always keep Blights in your sight, Blight in your sight, yeah, keep Blight in your sight, you should do okay. Okay, he's doing the sword attack again. Alright, all the swords, more swords. Ah, two more swords. There we go. You don't have to hit all the swords if you don't want to, but I suggest you do because they do come back. Oh, shit. Silly thing. silly Gold Nail. It's weird, because Blight definitely seems to be... He is the boss, but Gold Nail is like kind of like the core and essence of what Blight is. Which is kind of scary. But whatever. Ah, back here. Oop. Okay, he definitely seems to lose his mist too. What's he doing now? He's all like preparing for attack. Yeah. Get back here. Yes, excellent. Where's Gold Nail? There you are. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. Okay, 4, and then he seems to... 4 hits of a glaive, and he seems to make the mist happen again. So, perhaps... Maybe that's my advice to you? If you don't want to get hurt? I don't know. I'll accept my damage and time penalties for this. Because again, I just can't seem to figure it out. Yeah, and Power Slashes do nothing against him. Absolutely squat. So, it's almost kind of like, don't really waste your time with that. Alright, get rid of those swords. I'm gonna try one more. Ah, oh, okay, I got 5. That's cool. Or maybe I got 4 still. No, I think I got 4, because the glaives only do 3 in a row. Ooh, this is intense. Intense. And it stabs back into Blight and revives him. Oh, it's so creepy. Okay, what are you doing now, buddy? Get back here. No, you're just like a few hits away. Oh, what's he doing? Is he gonna like charge attack? Yeah. There we go. I kind of want to finish off Gold Nail as the final, but oh well. We'll attack Blight with his backup swords. He's kind of like a porcupine that way. Reminds me a little bit of that. Plus, I think he has like one of Orochi's head's helmets on his head. Just kind of weird. Ah! A weapon I will never use! Power! He obtained divine instrument and exorcism beads. Purifying rosary that contains the power of holy light. Blight, a disease residing within the Emperor's body and born of the intense hatred and evil of the cursed sword Gold Nail, was the source of the acrid mist that had plagued the capital citizenry. But even a creature so despicable and full of hatred is no match for our intrepid heroes, Amaterasu and Issun. Blight's defeat brought with it a lifting of the acrid fog. The Emperor, now freed of evil's influence, returned to normal. Amaterasu and the others had earned a brief moment of respite. However, evil conspired to cut the tranquil scene short. From Gold Nail's defeated form rose the familiar blackness, spirit of evil and hatred that had resided within the sword. Black as midnight, and deep as the sea, rose slowly skyward. Make no mistake, this was undoubtedly one of the foul spirits that dispersed from Orochi's broken body. Quickly and steadily it rose. Then it shot off towards the distant sea and over the horizon. It moved with purpose, as if to a rendezvous with a lost friend. Amaterasu and the others had no time to rest. If they were truly to restore the capital to normal routine, they still had to deal with the threat of the water dragon. This tale is far from over. Hey, you! Aren't you forgetting something? What? You had it coming big time, Gasbag! You aren't even in the same league as the magnificent Issun. Well, Furball, that's that. How about one of those victory howls? Oh wait, I almost forgot. That babe Kaguya is still locked up. Yeah, she is. Ugh, it's all like drippy and gross, ew. Ami, seems Pops is still snoozing away. How about we just take control and make him unlock her cell? Wow, we're really only going by her word that she's like not a bad person. Like, thankfully she's not. But we could be like freeing prisoners. Why bother with waking him up to explain everything anyway? Huh? You don't get it, do ya? Watch and learn, my furry friend. Cheesy soon. First, I'll stir up his stomach like this, and then... What the? Yikes! What the? Hey, are you okay, Ami? Looks like we managed to make the Emperor stand up. Come on, we gotta get this royal oaf moving. Let's get him over to where they're holding Kaguya. And yes, we are inside the Emperor's body now. But we'll free Kaguya in the next episode. So I thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you then.